3, 2, 1, go. Hello, my name is Dinkelberg, and I'll be showing you, explaining to you exactly who might win at the end of the race. First off, we're gonna start with Dinkelberg, or Dinkelberry, myself. We had a little typo, and we'll be using this equation right here to find out our time. Now, I will have a constant velocity of 9 miles per hour, or 4 meters per second once converted to the units that we require, which is meters per second. Now then, we're going to use this equation, so we're going to plug in for 1609 meters, which is the distance of the track, which is of course 1 mile equal to 1/2. We already stated that I would have a constant velocity, so it would be 9 miles per hour throughout the entire race. And my velocity final would of course be 9 miles per hour. My velocity initial would be 0 because we're starting from 0. We're starting from racing line. And that would be 9 plus 0. And the time, well, we're solving for t. And over here we will divide by 2, so we're technically multiplying by 2. So 1609 times 2, let me cross this out, and 2 times, over here what do we get? 2 times 1609, 18, 1, 0, 12, 3, and we get 3218 is equal to 19. Now we divide by 9. Okay, now coming back, we of course are dividing 3218 by 9. And for the purpose of time, I'll be using a calculator, and we will get 357.6 seconds. So Dinkelberg, or Dinkelberry, of course our typo, will be finishing the race in approximately 357.6 seconds, give or take. Of course, this is an estimation, and we very much like to have precise timing, but we will go off of the data that we have at the moment, which is of course the 4 meters per second constant velocity of Dinkelberg, his high skill, and his, because he doesn't have a special ability, we just simply leave those 4 meters per second. Now this of course will be the time needed for Dinkelberg to finish the race. Now we're going to move on to the next person, which is Esqueleto. And we're going to see how he varies with Dinkelberry near the end, of course, along with the other individuals. Now, Esqueleto's steps have a speed of 5 miles per hour on foot, 2.2 meters per second, 9.5 miles per hour on bike, which is equal to 4.2 meters per second. Of course, we're still using the same track, which is 1 mile long, and is equal to 1609 meters. Now, we're going to be using the same equation, so that we can find out time. And his special ability has an act of God, well, acts of God. And that's something in store for the rest of the race. His skill is medium, so we can expect a couple turnarounds or some falls here and there, of course, depending on what it is that he's on. So first we're going to start with the 5 miles per hour on foot and calculate the time that it would be if he, of course, runs the entire thing. We're going to use 2.2 meters per second. And of course, these are all constant velocities because we don't expect any changes, but we will account for that change near the end of this program. So we have 1609 meters, of course, is equal to 1/2. Velocity final would be 2.2 meters per second plus, we all start initially. And time, of course, we're solving for it. Now, of course, course, for the purpose of time and to keep our video short, we will be using a calculator for this segment. So 16.9 times 2 If Esqueleto runs the entire race on foot, he will finish in approximately 1,462.7 seconds. That would be seconds. Now, of course, we could leave that right there and box it up for you. Now, that's of course on foot, so let's label that as on foot. Now we will do the segment on bike, which of course is 4.2 meters per second. And we will start, of course, with the same equation, this one over here. And our distance is the same track, 1609, is equal to 1/2. Our final velocity is, of course, 4.2 meters per second, plus our initial velocity, which is 0. And our time t. Now, of course, for the purpose of time, we will be using a calculator. And 1609 times 2 for the 1/2, and then we divide by 4.2, and we get 762.66. Let's round that up to 2 seconds on bike. Now we will be accounting for instantaneous acceleration. That would, of course, now of course we'll take into account the fact that he might actually have his special ability, which is an act of God, and we'll do an instantaneous acceleration. So we'll have the 2.2 meters per second and the 4.2 meters per second. Now, because we have this large of a range, which we'll solve for right now. 696.5. So our range would be around 696.5 seconds. That's the difference in seconds between him being on foot and him being on foot. Now, because Esqueleto has been known to have his acts of God, we, of course, solve for the range, and that's kind of the range that we would be working in. So we can say that the fastest that Esqueleto could run this track, or this race, would, of course, be on bike at 700. So we'll be saying that this is the fastest that he can run his mile, the race, and this would be the slowest that he could run it, which would be on foot. This is all hypothetical, of course. These are the stats that we've been given by our sponsors. Now we will be moving on to Mbebe, who has a speed of 3 miles per hour, which converts to 1.3 meters per second, a skill of medium. His special ability is that he's potty trained. He is, of course, a child, a baby. And we'll be using the same equation as always to find out the time that he would finish the race at. Now, Oval will, of course, be using the 1609 meters. Is equal to 1/2 velocity final, which, of course, would be 1.3 meters. from here we will be using the calculator, of course. We'll be using the calculator, and 16.09 times 2 divided by 1.3 is equal to 2,475.38 seconds. That is a very long time for Eveve to finish the race. And the way it's looking right now with Escaleto's slowest time, it seems like Eveve might just come in last. But we still have another person, Milkman, who is, of course, our next individual. But this is the time that Eveve would take to finish a race of 1 mile, given that his only special ability is that he doesn't have to stop to change his diaper. Now let's move on to Milkman. Milkman, we come to our star player. Milkman has a speed of 8 miles per hour when he is on foot regularly. But Milkman has a special ability that adds 9 miles per hour when drinking milk. And Milkman is, of course, Milkman, so he will always have milk. But nonetheless, we will account for his speed both without the milk and with the milk. Now, first we need to convert the 9 miles per hour increase in speed, or, yeah, 9 mile per hour increase in speed, and convert that into meters per second. 9 miles per hour converts into 4 meters per second. 4 meters per second. Now, we'll be starting first with the time that it would take him first if he has no special ability. No special ability would be 1609 is equal to 1/2. Velocity final would of course be 3.6 meters per second plus 0 times time, or t, because we're solving for t. And we will again be using a calculator for the purpose of time. Divided by 3.6 is equal to 893.89 seconds. That is without his special ability. Okay, that is, of course, without his special ability, which is 893.89 seconds. Now we will move on to him with his special ability, which is plus 9 miles per hour. So that would mean that he would be moving at a constant, well, because his special ability is so fast, it would be considered an instantaneous acceleration, which means that there is little to no time in between the change in speeds, that we cannot account for that change in time. So we'll simply be changing the 8 miles per hour and the 9 miles per hour, and adding both of them into 17 miles per hour. So we'll be adding 4 meters per second plus 3.6 meters per second in order to get 7.6 meters per second. That would be his constant velocity throughout the race, because of course this is Milkman. Why would he not carry milk? I mean, it's in his name. It's in his nature as well. So then we will have 1609 is equal to 1/2, 7.6, plus 0, 5 times time. Now, of course, we will be using a calculator again for the purpose of convenience and time. Sorry about that. And we will be 1609 times 2. Meters per second, and we get 423.4 seconds. Wow. That is the fastest time yet. Well, looks like I have very high competition for Milkman. Looking at it now, the bebé has a time of 2,475.38 seconds. Comparing that to Milkman's special ability, of course, time, would be 423.4 seconds. Milkman will finish way faster than Mbebe. Of course, theoretically speaking. And then Esqueleto on the bike, even his fastest time would be 766.2 seconds. And his slowest time would be 1,462 seconds. So he'll be a lot closer to Mbebe, but of course, Milkman will be far gone by the time Escaleto gets to the finish line. And Dinkelberg, or Dinkelberry, as our misprints would say, our typo, is going to finish in 357.6 seconds. Awesome. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dinkelberg, and I'll be explaining, well, theorizing, who might get to the finish line first, between Milkman, Dinkelberg, myself, Esqueleto, or El Bebé? Now, we're going to start out utilizing kinematics, and these are the equations for kinematics. We'll of course be using kinematics because we have the possible units to find out exactly what it is that we need, which would be, we're solving for time. So of course we have time here, we have our velocities, which is our speed. We have our displacement on the x, which is of course the distance that we'd be running, which would be 1 mile, but converting to meters would be 1,609 meters. Our velocity for Dinkelberg is 9 miles per hour, which would equal to 4 meters per second. Now, why kinematics? Well, it's a lot simpler than using energy. So, of course, kinematics. You know, you just got your four equations, and we're done. Now, we're going to start by solving for time. Yeah, and that's actually all we'll be doing. So, we will be using 1609 meters, which would be our distance on the x-axis, is equal to 1/2 velocity final, which of course would be our 4 meters per second, plus 0, because we start from the starting line, which would be all the contenders, of course. And our time, well, t, we're solving for time. Now, for the purpose of time, of course, we will be using a calculator. And we will 1609 times 2 divided by 4, and we get t time is equal to 804.5 seconds is going to be the time it takes Dinkelberg to get across the finish line on his speed of 4 meters per second. His high skill, his special ability is of course none, so that could really be due to the fact of his very long time. But of course, this is the first person that we factor or solve for time. And his mode of transportation is going to be a bicycle. So we will add in bike. And on to the next person, which would, of course, be... Now, comparing Milkman's time to Dinkelberg's time, well, we see here that a Milkman still comes out in the lead, seeing as Dinkelberg would be finishing the race at 804.5 seconds. While Milkman, with his special ability, which would be a constant speed of 7.6 meters per second compared to Dinkelberg's 4 meters per second, would grant him a winning time of 423.4 seconds. So I'm afraid that for this race, our winner is, of course, Milkman. And congratulations to Milkman, if, of course, he wins. This is all theoretical, and all the physics is the way we explain our everything that goes on in our universe. A lot of things can change during this race, and a lot of things can happen to, I don't know, Esqueleto or Milkman himself. Maybe he runs out of milk, maybe he doesn't. That's all, folks, for now. Thank you for your time, and let's get back to the race.